Hi everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel. This is Onsi. Today in this video, I am going to discuss about data visualization with Python. It is a new concept of my YouTube channel. I am going to discuss for you. And in this video, I will briefly explain about what is mean by data visualization, what are the libraries we are used for data visualization. Like some data visualization graphs like line plot or bar plot, scatter plot, pie plot, like small examples I will explain today in this video. Okay, this is a series of this whole data visualization. Please make sure you want to follow and watch the video up to end. At the time only you can easily understand about the data visualization, how to use the data visualization, what is the necessary of the data visualization. At the end of this section of series of these videos, I will also explain what are the roles of the data visualization part and the job requirements, where you want to apply for the job of data visualization, and this, how much salary can the data visualization can earn. Like these simple things I will explain in this series of these videos. Okay, let's move into the video. Okay, data visualization with Python. It was sponsored by Code with You. Learn more to develop. Okay, at first, what is data visualization? So, data visualization is a process of translating the large data sets and the matrix into the charts, graphs, and other visualizers. It gives us a clear idea of what the information means by giving the context through the maps or graphs. Simply we can say what is mean by data visualization is it is a process of translating. If we have a large amount of data set, a billion records data set, human can't understand that much of data set, what is the columns, what are the things. By seeing he can understand this type of columns is there, this type of rows is there, but how much the data is, how the properly data is distribution, the human can't see that in a large data set. For that case, we can use the data visualization. That is, we can form that the data into the charts, graphs, and other visualization parts. So many parts is there, we can visualize that. Overall, the data visualization is a simple, it gives a clear idea how the data is clearly given in the data, how the data will be clear, which was given by the data set, it is occur in a correct order or not. Anything, the data we can visualize, the human can easily understand by the using the graphs and maps is simply known as the data visualization. Okay, right? I hope you are what is data visualization. And the next one is, what are the Python libraries we can use for data visualization? The Python libraries like MATLAB, lib, and seaborn, and etc. we are used for the data visualization part. Okay, and the next one is, why is data visualization needed? What is the uses of why we want to use the data visualization? What is the need of data visualization? For that, we need the data visualization because a visual summary of information makes it easier to identify the patterns and trends that looking through the thousands of rows on spreadsheet. It means it gives a clear summary idea about the information or patterns. What are the trends and patterns of which we have contained the thousands rows of data sets. Why the data visualization need more? Because it gives a perfect idea about the data set. Like human, we can easily understand what are the things in that data. It is very useful for us to using of data visualization. Okay. And the next one is type of data visualization. In how many types we can represent the data visualization? There is some more types. I will give some examples, like line graph, bar graph, scatter plot, pie plot, heap map, column chart, bubble chart, etc. These are the main things we can easily represent. The main idea of this thing is we don't remember the code. We don't want to remember the code. Simply Google it. But you want to remember that where we want to use which type of graphs. Where we want to use graphs or charts. Which type of graph is used in some cases. Which types of graphs are used in some cases. We want to clear about that. Then you can automatically write the data visualization codes. Just if you want to code, just to go and Google it. You can easily find about the code. Okay. I hope you have all understand up to now what is mean by data and data visualization. Why is data visualization needed and the types of data visualization. And I will simply explain about the line graph, scatter graph, bar graph, and pie graph. Okay, in this section of video, I will explain up to line graphs. And the next section, I will explain remaining graphs, what are the graphs necessary. Okay, but you want to more see about theoretically about these graphs. At first, I am going to discuss about line chart. What is mean by line chart? A line chart is a graphical representation of an asset's historical prices action that connects a series of data points with a continuous line. This is a most basic type of chart used in finance, and it is typically only dispatch a security closing prices over the time. It means we can simply know that a line chart is varied from the time. It moves so close to that time, and you can see the example beside this picture. Product trends by the month. In month, there is desktops, laptops, and tabs. These are the three products trends in the month. Where this is a line graph, which is there is a green line represented for the tabs. They sold from January to June. They have a lot of sales in tablets, and when we compare with the desktop, product sales is simply down. From January to June, it means the product sale is down. The people's users can't buy the desktops using of tabs. So another we have laptops. Like that, laptops sales is constantly increasing and decreasing. This is line chart. Where line chart is a simply it can vary with the time. If you have a time and if you take a restaurant data from 2 years, it can show you that we have which item sell high in this year, which item sell low in this year. We can say that if you have stock market, if you have added about stock market, you can see that interacting courses of data. Okay, these are overall about the line chart. And next we are going to discuss about now I am going to explain about the bar chart. Bar chart is one type of chart or graph that can represent the categorical data with the rectangular bars with height or length proportionally to the values that they are represented. The bar can be plotted in vertical or horizontal. A particular bar chart is sometimes called as a column chart. We can use bar chart for the categorical data type. For example, we can see the example from here. Here we have favorite colors and children's. Children are mostly like about yellow color, because these are the different types of categorical types: red, blue, green, yellow, pink. These are these five colors are different. So where the people nearly 9 members are liking yellow, their favorite color is yellow, whereas red is 8 members and 7 has blue and 5 has green and 6 has pink. Bar charts are used for the representation of categorical data. It may be in a horizontal or in a vertical. We can both type, we can represent it. Whereas a vertical bar chart is also known called as column chart. This is overall about the bar chart. And the next one is scatter plot. What is mean by scatter plot? Scatter plot is a type of plot to display the values of different variables for a set of data. If the points are quoted and one additional variable can be displayed, it is simply we can say that we can plot the scatter plot between the two different variables. For example, where in the y-axis we have taken height, whereas x-axis we have taken weight. This is a two different variables. For these two different variables, we are plotting the scatter plot. Scatter plot simply we can see like this points. See here point, like this. It means, for example, it's a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, like this. Nearly the weight of this person is like this. This is our data which scatter plot display for the, between the variables of age and weight and height. Simply, we can say that scatter plot is used for the display the values of two different variables to find how much the data is displayed in between the two variables. And the next one is pie chart. We are all know about the pie chart. When we have studied in our schooling also, we have learned about the pie charts, right? Yeah. What is mean by pie chart? A pie chart is a circular statistical graphic which is divided into slices to illustrate a numerical proportion. In a pie chart, the arc length of each slice is proportional to the quality of its representation. Presents. It means a slice, when you take a circular ring, by the radius we want to divide that circular. We can pass the diameters. Unlimited diameters is passes through the circle. So at the time, each diameter between the two radius is known as one slice. Like that only. In this graph also, population density index, whereas US, UK, India, Germany, Australia, South Korean, whereas blue represented as 40. So whereas this is one type of slice, this is one type of slice, which is 40 here. And green is UK. This is a one type of slice. This is one type of slice. Whereas red is a one India. It is a one type of slice. These are the whole are pie chart. In pie chart, we can divide it into slices. It means we are going to divide it into parts. Some parts. We want to divide some parts. Okay. And now we can go practical implementation of this graphs. Using Jupyter, I will show you now. Yeah, we have opened the Jupyter notebook. At first, in this series of first video, I will explain about the MATLABLIB, how to use MATLABLIB for the data visualization. Okay, Matplotlib was developed by the John D. Hunter in 2002. He was a neurophysicist. How the history of the Matplotlib is at the time of 2002, we have used the software of MATLAB. In that MATLAB, the only one user can use the software. In that case, John D. Hunter was think that to develop a software for multi-users. By the software of Matplotlib of backend version of its same syntaxes, he has developed the Matplotlib. We can say that Matplotlib is developed from the MATLAB. It is a thing about the history of MATLAB, and MATLAB is a plotting library for the Python programming language, and it is a numerical mathematics extension NumPy. It means it is a plotting library. We can plot. We can use for the plotting purpose, and it works on only on Python. And its numerical mathematical intentions. It works on. It's calculate the numerical values due to for NumPy, and it provides an object oriented API for the embedding parts into application using general purpose UGI toolkits like Tinker, WXPython, Qt or GTQ. It is a objected oriented APIs for embedding plots. For plots, it works as a object oriented APIs it used in general used in GUI, graphic user interface toolkits like these are the toolkits of graphic interface. Okay, and next we are moving to. For installation of Matplotlib, we use this line for installing the Matplotlib. Just to go to your command prompt, Python command prompt, and just run this code, pip install Matplotlib. Automatically downloaded it. Okay, if you want to install in Anaconda, just simply type the pip install conda Matplotlib, or you can search in the Anaconda environment navigator also, you can find there. And the version, which type of version we are using, just and run this code from first to try it. Now we are going to find the version. Just wait, my kernel is running. Yeah, 3.3.2, it is our version of this Matplotlib. And I am going to input this libraries NumPy, pandas, MATLAB. Whereas NumPy is used for numerical data or arrays, and pandas are used for data frames, and Matplotlib is used for plotting and C1. And in this series of videos I will explain about the C1 also. It is also used for data visualization purpose, and the percent model percent matplot inline, it's represent the, to show the plots when you are going to show the plot.show. We don't want to use that function when you have write the percent matplot inline. This is an simply we can say it's for showing plots. Okay. And we are previously we have discussion about line, right? Line plot, and this is a what is mean by line, line plot, and how these graphs are occur. But in this video, I am going to explain about line plot. I am going to explain practical implementation, how to implement the line plot like that. Okay, let's move into that. Whereas a line plot, line chart, a line chart is a graphical representation. Simply, we can say that it is varied with the time. It forms the time. Okay, for that it is a simple example where x is equals to numpy dot array arrange 0 to 1 and y is equals in np dot arrange 11 to 21. Why I have taken this 0 to 11, 10 and 11 to 21? Let's see here. Where x is a output of print x is equals to array dot 0 1 2. I have given 0, but it's end with starting value is 0 but ends with 10. But output we can't get a 10. Why? because in Python indexes are starts from 0, like that 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, like that. When you have upload this in values, last it's simply we can say that starting point, starting value, ending value minus 1. It is a formula for this getting array. If you see that here the 11, we have starting value is 11 and the ending value is 20, but here is 20. It means starting value, ending value minus 1. Starting value is 11. Yes, see, starting value is 11, here also 11. Ending value is 21 minus 1. 21 minus 1, 20. We can get 21 minus 1, 20. Simply we can get. And we are going to plot x and y. The output of this plot is like this. Output of plot is like this. This is a xy plot. It's it is a simple plot. We want to decorate it more to see more things. It will appear. It won't access and markers, access title, legendary, so many things. It is looking some simple plot. We want to decorate. It's very beautiful. For that case, I am using another example for adding the line title and axes. For this, I am using the example x is equals to np dot arrange array arrange 0 to 10. It will take 0 to 9 because starting value, ending value minus 1. Okay, y, whereas y is equals to 2 into x plus 10. What is y? Can I print this? Just wait. I will show you what is x and y. When pass the x 0, 1, 2, 3, and I will pass the y. Let's see. When you pass the x, x is 0, 1, 2, 3, where here the y is 2 into x plus 10, 0, 0 into 2, 0, 0 plus 10. 2 into 1, 2, 2 plus 10, 12, here, 0 into 2, 0, 0 plus 10, 10, this is a formula I have written here, okay, and we are having plot dot title and plot dot title, I am giving the title as a line chart and the plot dot x axis, x label, x axis, plot dot y label, y axis and plot dot xy, and we have plotted this value. It's some better when we compare to the previous one. In previous we have get only the graph, but in this line we have get some title, axes. Another we want to go, another we can example, we can move to look the graph more beautiful. Like I am using this method where x is goes np dot arrange of 10 to 31. I have taken the starting value is 10 and ending value is 30. Whereas ending value is 31 minus 1 is 30, where y is equals to 5 into x minus 2, whereas 5 into 10, 50, right, 5 into 10 minus 2. If you want to put this thing, I want to show you. Where x is equals to 10, 11, 12, up to 30 and y is equals to 48, 53, 58, this is a formula which I have using here. I have used here. This is a formula of y. We can get these values and we have plotted these values. Right? At 148, it is a 148, it is a peak stage. It is a peak of 148. Okay. Now we are seeing that some better thing to see. This is some better idea. Is looking different lines. Here are the lines, the markers. We can simply, if you want to know what are the parameters attributes between this plot, you can just shift plus tab. You can see this pop-up window. In that you can use anything. This is the types. What are the things you want to attribute? So this is the main thing. If you can use anywhere, this thing. Just okay. I will show you this for you. Just copy here. us here the what is mean by GO dash dash. Here G is a color, O is a marker, and dash dash is a style. Simply we can write this. If you want to use a long method, you can use like XY comma color is equals to blue, line length is equals to like this. You want to do more things. So for that case, for simple way, we can use this G order, or we can use like this also. So see that if you want to put star, it can be printed as a star. These are our things. It looks some beautiful thing, more beautiful than the previous ones. And the next one is subplots. How can we plot the subplots in a figure? For that case, I'm using this subplot function. Whereas a plt dot subplot 2, 2, 1, it means two rows, two columns, first row. Two rows, two columns, first row. Where plot dot plot xy color is equals to green. I plot the 2, 2 rows, 2 rows, two columns for green, and second one is plot subplot of 3, 2. It means three rows and two columns. For three rows and two columns, I will print for red color. So just execute it, and we can get here. It is a 2x2 plot subplot. It is a 3x2 subplot. Okay, whereas green is located for the 2x2 subplot, whereas red is located for the 3x2 subplot. Okay, I hope you are understand about this overall thing. It is a simple graph of line graph, and this is looking for more better to graph, and this is a more beautiful to look with different colors and the markers, anything further. And the last one is I have shown that subplots, how to create a subplots also, and this is a assignment problem for you. Please try to do in your own. After that, you can easily know how to do the plots, how to present the plots of line plots. These are the things you can learn easily. Please make sure you want to do this assignment from your own, after your own. And I have already executed, but try once try you. Okay, I will where you want to upload these assignments in next week. I am going to give some mail for you. Please send this mail for codewithyou30@gmail.com. I will check and feedback for your works. This is the final thing about this line plot. And the next video, I will explain about the bar plot, scatter plot, and pie plot with examples and different types of plots and examples. And in that only I will explain about the histogram also, how to form the histograms and different types of plots also. I will explain about that. I hope you are all understand about this first series of this data visualization video about what is briefly understanding of the different plots. The basic four, these are the four basic plots are used in the codes. And don't worry about the coding section. It will just Google it. You can find easily about the coding section. Just to make an idea and where we want to use which type of plots. This is the main thing you want to keep in your mind. Just think in a practical way. Just how go through the data set. What type of variables we are taking for what type of graphs. This is the main thing. Okay. And I hope you are understand about this video. Please like and subscribe to our YouTube channel for more updates about any related technologies like data science, Android development, web development, any technologies. We are going to introduce any new concepts about that in a simple way. Hard concepts also we are teaching in a simple way. We can easily understand and get a jobs. And one more thing I want to say for you that we are preparing something for the interview preparation also. For different roles, you can get easily that. If you want to know about that, please make comment in comment. I will share the details so you can join there. Okay, friends, bye. Let's see on next video. Bye bye.